फिर सेफ एंड फाइन एट योर होम। टुडे आई हैव ब्रॉट ए ब्यूटिफुल कोटेशन फॉर यू। इफ यू कैन स्टे पॉजिटिव इन ए नेगेटिव सिचुएशन यू विन। ओके, आई लाइक दिस बिकॉज वी आर रियली गोइंग थ्रू अ डिफिकल्ट कंडीशन ड्यू टू दिस COVID-19 पैंडेमिक। सो or sometimes we are not, means sometimes not, we are getting complaint always that since real classroom teaching is not happening, you people are facing problem, doubts are there, and you are not able to understand the things properly. Okay, but still we are trying to make you understand, to give you everything, and if you will think that this is the condition and we have to cope up and we have to utilize this fully, then you can win also. So this COVID-19 will not become an obstacle for you to for your study. Okay, so not also for us and not for you also. So all both the teachers and student, we live in a positive situation so that we can win. Okay, let us go to the lesson now. So previous class we are studying about computer means protocols I started. So today about to details in protocols. Okay, so protocols I told, what is that protocol? Protocols are the set of the rules to be followed over rules to be followed during data transmission over network. Okay, protocols are the set of rules to be followed during data transmission over network. Okay, so how the data transmits, I told you previous class, data means nothing but it transmits the as signals. Signals are converted to packets, small chunks known as your packets, and those signals are transmitted through the network. Okay, so how these protocols we use for transmission of data, that we'll study today. Two important protocols we use, that is your transmission control protocol and internet protocol. Actually, these are two protocols. One is your transmission control protocol and one is your internet protocol. But these two protocols always use as one. So, combinedly used everywhere. So, one name given, that is TCP/IP. And another protocol is important is there, that is your hypertext transfer protocol, HTTP. So we'll learn about details about these protocols, because these two protocols are important for data transmission. Other protocols are also there, but they are not in your syllabus. So we'll read about these two protocols in detail now. So what is transmission control protocol? See, transmission control protocol and internet protocol always use combinedly. So they treated always as, although they are two protocol, but they treated as always one protocol. Transmission Control Protocol TCP and Internet Protocol IP are two important and commonly used protocols. Both are used in a combination on the internet. TCP/IP specifies how data is exchanged over the internet by providing end-to-end communications that identify how it should be broken into packets, addressed, transmitted, routed, and received at the destination. So what is this end-to-end communication? It is end-to-end means is from sender to receiver. Means one is sending the data and other is receiving the data. That identify how it should be broken into packets. I told the message, whatever message we are sending, whatever the files we are sending, data we are sending, that will convert it into small packets, that every packet has its own address. They will be transmitted through sequence to reach at the other end. So these all works, how the from sender to receiver the data will reach, that is the work of your transmission control protocol and internet protocol. Okay, so now function of TCP, what TCP work and what TCP is doing and what IP is doing, we'll learn today. Okay, TCP defines how application can create channels of communication across a network. It also manages how a message is assembled into smaller packets before they are transmitted over the internet and reassembled in the right order at the destination address. That is the work of your TCP. That means TCP responsibility is to divide the message into small parts and then attaching a serial number to all the messages, and then it will see how the messages will be transmitted in a particular order so that it will reach at the destination in that order, and it can reassembled so that the original message we can get. Okay, suppose I will give one example. Suppose you are sending the message, how are you? And see if the suppose those messages will be converted into signals and the signals will be transmitted. If the same message will not get how are you, and it is altered in between how you are or something like this, it will be deserted, then what will happen? The correct original message will not able to get. Okay, so it is very important that packets will be sent in the order and it will be reassembled in the destination address properly. Okay, so next, what actually TCP other things take care. For example, TCP facilitates reliable data transfer by ensuring that each packet gets transmitted. That means, for example, ensuring all the attachments of an email are sent. You know that using email we can send big files also, like using attachment. So suppose if you are sending email, it will take care that all the attachments of the file reached at the destination end. There is no delay in transmission. That means ensuring that there is no lag between sound and picture in a video call. That means suppose you will watch a video and you will find that the sound and video is not matching, then you will not feel good to watch that video. So it is the responsibility of TCP that to synchronize both the video and the audio. Okay, packets are appropriately reassembled at the receiver's end. That is, instant messages are not deserted when received. Packets are appropriately reassembled at the receiver's end. So now one example I have given. Suppose you will give some message, and if that properly it will not be reassembled, then the meaning of the message will be something else. Okay, so it will be a problem. Correct message will not get and the meaning of the message will be changed. So reassembling of the message is also important. Okay, so now come to one important thing. So how TCP is doing this work? TCP provides a sequence number and a delivery timeline to each packet. I told 1, 2, 3, 4 or whatever it generates automatically. If it is not transmitted within the given deadline, the source host sends a second copy of that packet. So due to any network traffic, if any packet will not reach in time with the other end, then it will be sent by the source. It will be sent by the source again. Okay, and all packets of the original messages are received and rearranged based on the sequence number. Okay, so whatever the sequence number will be given by the TCP at the sender's end, then they will be reassembled at the receiver's end with the same sequence number, so that the message can be received originally. Okay, next, your internet protocol, IP. What IP does? IP defines how to address and route each packet to make sure it reaches the right destination. Each network device has a unique address called IP address. That also you know. Suppose one mobile to another mobile or one computer to another computer you are sending the data, then every computer or every device connected in the network has a unique address called IP address. Each packet contains an IP header with key information, such as what information? Along with the IP address, other informations like it identification and identification flag, which helps to reassemble data in the correct number. Okay, time to leap flag, which indicates the maximum number of hops the data can make from the source to the destination before it loses strength. Okay, means you know the signal becomes weak while traveling. So we are using different device to re-amplify the signals, like our switches are there, router is there. So different devices we are using so that if the signal will lose its strength to before reaching at the destination, then it can be amplified. Okay, so this helps switches and routers to choose the best route. So along with the IP address, what extra information goes with the packet? Identification flag, which helps to reassemble data in the correct number. Time to leap flag, which indicates the maximum number of hops the data can make from the source to the destination before it loses strength. Okay, so these are the information which attached with the packet while the message travels from your source to the destination. And who does this work for the does this work? TCP and IP combined. Okay, so now come to hypertext transfer protocol. Hypertext transfer protocol, actually it is used to send and receive multimedia data. It is used to transfer data between web browser and servers on the world wide web. HTTP is used to transferring information like document, file, image, video between computers over internet. Okay, it operates via request and response messages sent between the devices. The three main HTTP messages types are given below. Okay, so now I'll tell HTTP hypertext transfer protocols are used to send and receive multimedia data from using your web browser through World Wide Web, means www. Okay, so it operates via request and response messages. Request and response, you know, sometimes you are searching information in the web, means your internet, whatever you are telling, you are using Chrome for that or any other web browser, then you are typing your question, then some answers you are getting, that means you are requesting for something, then the response are coming to you. So that is your request and response messages sent between the devices. Okay, and it is used to transferring information like document, file, image, video between computers. And when all these things combine together, we tell it as multimedia data. Okay, text, image and sound, graphics, when combined together, we tell it as multimedia data. And for the transmission of multimedia data, HTTP is very responsible. Okay, so what are the three types of HTTP messages are there, that we'll read now. One is your get message. What is get message? These are used to access a web page by sending the required URL. URL, now all of you understood, that is whenever you have started these online classes during this pandemic time, so all of you understood what is URL. You are using campus care, sometimes campus care not working, it is asking for URL, so you are giving curly.campuscare.info, then you are getting the information. So sometimes you are searching other things also, every day you are getting one URL from the YouTube to watch the videos of your different subjects. So what is URL here? URL is your uniform resource locator. You can tell it is the address of the website where you will get the information. Okay, the HTTP server then returns the web page to the web browser, for example opening a website. Clear? So whenever you are typing any address to get a website, to open a website, that is a through get message, it is working through get message. Okay, so what is the next one? So one is your post message. These are used for submitting additional information such as entering usernames or making online payment. So nowadays these are very popular, entering username, you are doing in campus care every day, your username and password and other things also, whenever you are doing all online shopping or something, you are giving your username and password, so for online payment. So these are used for submitting additional information, that is your post messages. Then what is head message? These are used to retrieve only a certain information about the web page rather than the contents of the web page itself, such as checking if the web page has been updated since last accessed or not. That means whenever you don't want to see the information, and but you want to see whether it is updated web page or not, when it is updated and when it is uploaded, suppose this type of information if you want to see, then that type head message works. Okay, so three messages are there. One is your get message, one is your post message, another one is your head message. Using this, the HTTP is working. That means it is means we are able to download and upload the multimedia files. Okay, the secured hypertext transfer protocol or HTTP is used for a secure exchange of information between the browser and the server, that all of you know. While entering sensitive information such as password or credit card details during an online shopping transactions, HTTP encodes the data such that it can be accessed only by the particular user and the server. Otherwise, what will happen? Our important information will be leaked, it can be hacked and it can be misused by others. So there is one layer between the server and the user, to protect our important information, and that time the hyper HTTP protocol come into existence to seal this information from others. Okay, so HTTP is what? HTTP plus secure encoding, when combined together, that it becomes your HTTPS. HTTP used for transmission of multimedia data, and plus secure encoding is also attached with it, that becomes your HTTPS. Okay, so with this, I think this lesson completed with today. We completed the lesson. So next class we'll do some your exercise. We'll do. I will send you the exercise, and today I will send some questions also. All of you do it in your copy. And doubt classes are going on. You collect your doubt at one place, and whenever doubt class will go on, you ask your doubt. Whoever teacher takes the doubt class, no problem. You collect your doubt. Before that, you watch all the videos so that your doubt will be clear. And after that, it will not be clear. Then doubt classes are going on. For that's why you attend the doubt class, everybody. Don't give simple excuses like my network was not working, I am having a tuition and all that. So don't give this such type of silly excuses. You attend the doubt classes, it will be beneficial for you. Okay, so have a good day. All the best.